a reckless attack.
I am tired of depending on others, especially my friend Martha and my husband. Wait a minute, what's on that post advertisement?
Whitney and her husband Tony were recently married couples. They lived in a South Indian village. A month after their wedding, Tony had to go abroad to work in a foreign country. There was no one to stay with Whitney. Her close friend, Martha, invited her to stay with her. Whitney closed their house and moved to her friend's house in the town. Martha had a daughter called Meena, who was very fond of Whitney. Whitney was very affectionate to the child and was eager to look after every need of the child with tender love and care. Few months later, Tony called to inform Whitney that he was back, so she had to go back to her husband's house, but on her way home, this happened.
This post have an advert space for new hires wanted. This job might favor me. I am tired of staying at home so lonely, and with all the debts we have, I need to support my husband. Let me quickly call and tell them I am interested.
Hello.
She called the number and the person who picked the call asked her to come to the address he will be sending to her.
I hope they reply back soon. Oh, that was quick. Let's see the address. This person wants us to meet in a park. Why would he or she want us to meet in the park? This sounds strange. God, please help and guide me. I really need a job, but please Lord protect me and grant me a good job in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. Oh, I think this is the last stop. Excuse me.
Yes, how may I help you?
Please, where can I get a bus to Temple Park?
Temple Park. I will advise you take the next train and stop at the next stop. The park opposite the station is Temple Park.
Okay, thanks so much.
She quickly took the next train, got off the train and headed straight to Temple Park. Right in front of the park, she called the number again and the person directed her to where he was waiting for her.
Finally you are here. I thought you wouldn't make it.
Well, I checked the location and discovered it wasn't far from where I was. And since I am in desperate of a job, I have no choice but to come.
That's fine. So, did you come with your CV and qualifications?
I don't have the hard copies here, but I have them on soft copies. I promise to bring it when I get the job.
That's great. Soft copies will do for now. Now come, let's go.
Okay. Thanks so much.
Whitney followed the man to their office, which is not far from the park, and this happened.
Where is this place?
Here is our office. So now, I will take you to our boss, who will interview you.
Okay.
He took her into an office where she met a strange man.
Hello, I am Alberto. Welcome to the connection spot.
Hello, sir. My name is Whitney, Whitney Davies. Thanks so much, sir, for the opportunity to be here.
That's fine. Please sit. Let's get to know you.
Thank you, sir.
I am looking at your CV, and I can see that you have not been working for a long time. So tell me, what exactly can you do?
Anything, sir. I can clean, cook, wash, and I can also do any office work, sir.
Interesting, I like that.
The man, after interviewing her, was impressed. He then asked her to resume work as a receptionist the following week. She was so happy that she went home to share the good news to her husband.
Why is my wife taking so long to return? Where else has she gone to? I cannot believe that my wife has started keeping late night. How come she is out these late? So this is what she does whenever I go out to work for us. What is all this? Where are you coming from?
Guess what, honey?
What?
I have finally got a job. Now I can work and support you financially, and with the extra income, we can pay off all our debts.
You do. But why didn't you tell me you were going out to look for a job?
Well, that is because I don't want you to discourage me. I am tired of watching you suffer alone to take care of this family. Every time you had to travel outside the country to make ends meet, still the money you make isn't enough.
But I am not complaining.
But the landlord, your friends you are owing, and the bank we loan money from last year are all complaining.
Look, woman, I will work very hard to settle all our debts, but as for you, you have to stay back home and look after the house.
Please, Tony, I am only doing this for us. Last time I checked, this house is so empty, We need kids, but I understand that we need money before we start raising kids. But also remember that I am a woman, and time isn't on my side. We need to work hard together to achieve our dreams.
I know, and I am working on that. Listen, I can't afford to lose you to anyone. I don't trust those rich men who pretend under the disguise of helping or granting you a job, only to lure you to their beds.
What? Come on, Tony. We've been married for 4 years. You still don't trust me.
Well, I do, but I know you're only human, and knowing what you did for a living in the past as a prostitute, before you gave your life to Christ, gives me a big concern.
Oh my God, Tony, so you still don't trust me. So this is why you don't want me to work, socialize or even meet your friends. Because of my past, I love Jesus, I am a new creature in Him. My past is my past, and my present is in Christ Jesus. Please, trust me and give me the opportunity to show you that I am a different person now.
Okay, that's fine. I trust you.
Whitney was so happy that her husband finally gave his approval for her to work. This gave her a big relief and she couldn't wait to start supporting him financially.
Hello, Whitney. How are you doing?
Oh, Martha, you cannot believe that my boss gave me salary raise.
Wow, that's good news. Congratulations.
Oh, let me speak to my darling Meena. Is she there with you?
Yes.
Few months later, Whitney was at home after a long day at work, while at home waiting for her husband who went to town and could return only by dusk. When he got back home, he heard the loud sound of Whitney. Obviously, she was on the phone, speaking to someone. Out of curiosity, Tony secretly listened to the words of his wife. He was shocked to hear her words. She was talking very affectionately to someone on the phone and stated that she loved that person more than anything else in this world. She even made the sound of a loving kiss.
Meena, where is this girl? Meena, come and speak to your auntie.
Yes, Mom. Hello, auntie. I have missed you.
My darling, oh how I have missed you so much, my love. Here's a kiss from me to you.
Yes, auntie. I love you so much.
I love you more, my darling. Don't worry. I will make sure I call you always, okay?
So my wife is now sleeping around with her boss. I will deal with this woman. A prostitute is always a prostitute. My friends and family warned me, but I didn't listen. How do I break this bad news to them that my wife is sleeping with her boss? I married this woman because I thought she is actually a changed person and a born-again Christian, but no, she deceived me.
I will visit again.
Oh. Tony could not bear this. He believed that she had a secret lover and was sharing intimate moments with him. He angrily pushed the toilet door open and went in to confront his wife.
Bye.
You prostitute, so this is what you do at work.
Furiously, he grabbed a heavy stick from the toilet window and gave an unexpected heavy blow on her head. She gave a loud cry and fell down, fainted. Filled with rage, Tony took the phone and listened silently, hoping to identify the criminal. There was a repeated inquiry from an excited lady through the phone, screaming, Whitney, Whitney,
Hello,
what happened
Whitney.
To you?
Whitney, Whitney, what happened?
Who are you?
John, is that you?
Ha, huh. Martha, is that you?
Yes, John, my daughter was speaking to Whitney, and then I heard her scream. Is she okay?
Oh my God, what have I done?
What have you done to Whitney? Answer me.
I had foolishly misunderstood my wife and misinterpreted her sweet talk to your innocent daughter Meena.
Oh my God. What did you do? What have you done?
We'll speak to you soon. I have to call the ambulance.
He felt extremely sorry for reacting impulsively to Whitney's innocent act of affection and inflicting a serious injury on his dear and loving wife. Whitney was rushed to the hospital in his car. She had to undergo a major emergency surgery. Her head retained marks of the trauma.
Yes, come in. Oh no, my darling. Hey Martha, thanks for coming. Please my darling, don't cry. Please come here.
Martha was shocked to see her friend turned sister in such bad state. She wept so bitterly, knowing what Whitney has gone through in life before marrying Tony. She was the one who led Whitney to Christ Jesus, and Whitney has always been a good friend to both herself and her daughter. This hurts Martha so much that she ordered the arrest of Tony. Although Whitney wasn't in support of the arrest, but Martha insisted and arrested him. Few months later, this happened.
You have a visitor. Please came with me.
Okay, officer. Hey, Martha. How is my wife doing? Is she okay?
Yes, she is.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
But why, Tony?
Why what?
Why would you hit a woman you claimed you loved? I thought you were a Christian.
I am a Christian.
No, you are not. You're a monster pretending to be a Christian.
No, I am not.
Well, I am not here to judge you, but many people like you think that going to church occasionally or simply believing in God makes them a Christian. But the Bible presents a different perspective and definition of a Christian. A Christian is someone whose behavior and heart reflects Jesus Christ. Let me remind you also that following God involves serving others, not manipulating and controlling them. Jesus told his disciples, "Whoever wants to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wants to be first must be your slave." Just as the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many, Matthew 20:26-28. His command to us is to love one another, John 13:34. Ephesians 5, 1-2 says, "Follow God's example, therefore, as dearly loved children and walk in the way of love, just as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us as a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God." Christians are called to sacrificially love others, especially those in their own families. What I'm trying to say to you is that if you are a true Christian, you would never lay your hands on your wife. Scripture is full of condemnations of violence, and again violence is associated with wickedness and it is condemned as detestable to the Lord, and that scripture is in Psalm 11, Proverbs 3 and 10. A moment of misunderstanding or misinterpretation may be very disastrous and may make a couple forget the millions of memorable moments in their life and lead to erroneous or dangerous conclusions and decisions. It is wrong to draw conclusions until we know all the facts. Judge not, and you will not be judged. Condemn not, and you will not be condemned. Forgive, and you will be forgiven, as written in Joshua 22, 9-24. Whitney loves you so much and can never cheat on you. She is not the Whitney you know before. Yes, she was a prostitute, but that was in her past. In Isaiah 43, 18-19, forget the former things, do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up, do you not perceive it?
I am so sorry for what I have done, and I wish I could turn back the hands of time, so as to undo that which I have done to my precious wife. Please, can you ask her to find it in her heart to forgive me?
Well, I suggest you do that yourself.
But how? I am locked up here in this cell and I can't see her.
Well, she has ordered your release through her boss. So you are now a free man.
Oh, really?
Tony was released and he went home to his wife to apologize.
Oh no, I am so sorry, honey. I allowed the spirit of jealousy to take over me. Please forgive me. I am a changed Christian, and I promise never to control or hit you ever again.
It's okay, honey. I miss you. Come here.
If I may ask, is your eyes okay?
Yes, I only wear this glasses to protect my eyes from the sunlight, as it's still in the process of healing. But other than that, I can see with it.
Oh, thank God. I was so scared when I saw you wearing glasses. I thought my stupid act has led you to lose your sight. Please find it in your heart to love me again. I am so sorry.
I have long forgiven you before you asked. I mean, the Bible in Ephesians 4:32 states, "Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you." I forgive you over and over again. Come, go have your shower. Your food's ready in the kitchen.
The couple's reconciled. They both saved enough money to pay off their debts. Few years later, God blessed them with three beautiful children, triplet, and they all lived happily ever after.
Story by Quincy Onyekachi Okoye Oragwa. If you enjoyed this video, please kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, hit the like button, leave a comment, and don't forget to share. Thanks for watching.